Hello scholars, welcome back to our online classes of GK. Today we are going to start our unit 2. But before that, I know you all are waiting to know the answers of the questions which I have asked in my last video. So let's see the answers. Our question number 1 was, who was the first Twitter user to reach 20 million followers? The answer is Lady Gaga. Lady Gaga just became the first Twitter user to reach 20 million followers. Now, we'll see our question number 2. Where can you find cities, towns, shops and streets but no people? The answer is map. In a map, we can find all of these but no people. So now scholars will move to do the exercise of our book. Scholars, today we will start our second unit, that is flora and fauna. Before starting this chapter, we should know what is flora and fauna. Flora is all the plant life present in a particular region or time, generally the naturally occurring native plants, and the corresponding term for animal life is fauna. In simple words, the flora relates to all plant life and the term fauna represents all animal life. So scholars, now we will start our exercise number 9 given on page number 9, that is reptiles and mammals. What are mammals? Mammals are animals which give birth to babies and feed them their milk. And reptiles? Do you know what is a reptile? An animal that crawls or moves on its belly or on small short legs. They usually lay eggs that hatch to give birth to the baby reptiles. So in this exercise, what we have to do? We have to look at these pictures and we have to write R if it is a reptile and we have to write M if it's a mammal. So scholars, I want you all to do this exercise yourself, as here you just have to find out whether these animals are reptile or mammal. So do it yourself. Like, I'll tell you one example. Like, our first one is crocodile. So crocodile is a mammal or a reptile? Yes, you're right. Crocodile is a reptile because we have seen crocodile crawling on the ground and crocodile lay eggs also. So here in the given box, we will write R because crocodile is a reptile. In the same way, our second question is tiger. Yes, tiger is a mammal because tiger gives birth to their babies. So here in the box given, we will write M for tiger because tiger is a mammal. So in the same way, I want you all to do this exercise yourself. And the answer of this exercise is given in the PDF in the link below. So after doing that, you can check your answers. Okay, so now we'll move to our next exercise. So now we have reached to our exercise number 10, that is animal world. So we have to look at these pictures, read the clues given down and name the animals. So let's start this exercise. Our question number 1 is, this animal is a mammal but it lay eggs. You will find it in Australia. Can you recognize it? No, it is platypus. The platypus is a duck-billed, weaver-tailed, otter-footed, egg-laying aquatic creature native to Australia. Is found only in Australia, is one of the 5 mammal species of that lay eggs instead of giving birth to young ones. Now, we'll move to our question number 2. This animal, when faced with a predator, sprays a foul-smelling liquid on the predator's face. Can you recognize this animal? You must have seen this animal in a famous story, Jungle Book. No, it is skunk. A skunk's spray is an oily liquid produced by glands under its large tail. To employ this scent bomb, a skunk turns around and blasts its foe with a foul mist that can travel as far as 10 feet. So this is a really very interesting quality of skunk. Now we'll move to our question number 3. Which is the largest lizard in the world and is found only in Indonesia? The answer is Komodo dragon. Komodo dragon is the largest lizard. They reaches to an average length of 8 feet and may weigh up to 300 pounds. Now we'll move to our question number 4. This is a fish which can breathe air and live on land for extended period of time. It is mud skipper, a fish with eyes on raised bumps on the top of the head, found in mangrove swamps from East Africa to Australia. They are amphibians fish. So you will write here mud skipper. Now we'll move to our question number 5. This intelligent animal is also known as the man of forest and is found in the forest of Indonesia. It is orangutan. These great apes share 96.4% of our genes and are highly intelligent creatures. The name orangutan means man of the forest in the Malay language. So write here orangutan. Now we'll move to our question number 6. This scaly animal loves to eat termites, ants and rodents. Yes, it looks quite like a rat, but it is not a rat, it is armadillo. It is a small mammal with a shell of armored plates that protect them from predators. With their long sticky tongue, armadillos catch ants, beetles, termites and insects after digging them out of the ground. So we will write here armadillo. So now we have completed our exercise number 10. Now we will do our exercise number 11. So here is our exercise number 11, that is beaks and claws of birds. The structure of a bird's beak determines the type of food it is able to eat, and the structure of its feet or claws determines its function, like grasping, scratching, etc. So here we have been given with the description of the beak and claws of a bird. We have to answer according to that description. So let's see the question. So here is our question number 1. I am a kingfisher. I have a long and pointed beak that helps me to catch fish. My beak is shaped like a. The options are spear or strainer. The shape of kingfisher beak is like a spear. You know what is a spear? A weapon with pointed tip, typically of steel, and a long shaft used for thrusting or throwing. So a kingfisher beak is also like that only. So here we will write a spear. Now we'll move to our question number 2. I am a parrot. I have a strong curved beak that helps me to eat hard and unripe fruits like mango and guava. The shape of my beak is like a. The options are tweezer or crusher. Our answer is crusher, because they use it for climbing as well as crushing. Now we'll move to our question number 3. I am a duck. I have a broad and flat beak with tiny holes called shovels in the sides. It helps me to dig mud near the ponds to pick up worms, insects which I eat for food. My beak is shaped like a. The options are a strainer or probe. So our answer is a strainer. The duck use their beaks to filter insects and algae out of the water and into their mouths. Now we'll see our question number 4. I am a woodpecker. I have 2 toes pointing upwards and 2 toes pointing downwards, which help me to cling to the bark of trees. The structure of my claws is ideal for. The options are climbing or scratching. So our answer is climbing. Now we'll move to our last question of this exercise, that is question number 5. I am a crow. I have 4 toes, 3 in front and 1 at the back. My toes help me to hold the branch of a tree very firmly. The structure of my claws is meant for. The options are flying or perching. So our answer is perching. Claws on feet are used for grasping the prey, for perching, for scratching the ground or fighting. So like this we have completed our exercise number 11. Now we'll move to our exercise number 12. So here is our exercise number 12, that is animal adaptations. Animals develop special features and abilities to live and survive in their particular habitat, that is natural place of living. This is called adaptation. So here on this page, some animals, their habitats and the adaptation they have developed are given in 3 different columns. We have to match them correctly by drawing lines. So I want you to do this exercise yourself. Let me tell you how you will do this. As you can see here, there are 3 columns. In the first column, the animals are given. In the second column, their habitat, in which surrounding or environment they live. And in third column, adaptations that is required to live in that environment is given. So what we have to do here, just see with first example. Our question number 1 is polar bear. So polar bear lives in what kind of habitat? Just find out from the middle row. It is given in point number 5. That is very cold Arctic region. So what we will do? We will match the first with the 5th. Now what type of adaptation the polar bear needs to live in very cold Arctic region? It is given in point number B. That is thick fur and thick layer of fat under the fur called blubber. So we'll match number 5th with B. Okay, so like this you have to do for all these 4 animals. Try to do it yourself. It is very simple. And after doing this, you can check your answer from the PDF given in the link below. So like this, we have completed our exercise number 12. Now rest of the exercise we'll do in our next video. Now we will move to our next segment, that is Amazing Facts. So scholars, today in the segment of Amazing Fact, we'll learn about black apples. Yes, you heard right. Black apples exist. These extremely rare apples look like something out of a fairy tale. Black diamond apples are a rare variety from the family of Huanyu apples, also known as the Chinese Red Delicious. The name is a little misleading because they are not exactly black, but rather a dark color of purple.
These unique apples owe their color to their native geography in Ningxi, a small city in the mountains of Tibet, where they receive a lot of ultraviolet light during the day, but the temperature fluctuates dramatically at night, causing the skin to develop a deep dark color. The flesh inside is white and bright like any other apple. So next time, if you get a chance to visit Tibet, don't forget to have these apples. Now let's move to our next segment, that is Know Your Country. Today in this segment, we are going to learn about one interesting fact about India, that is the floating post office. With 1,55,618 post offices and over 5,66,000 employees, India has the largest postal network in the world. But did you know India is also having a floating post office? The floating post office is located in the beautiful city of Srinagar in Kashmir. Amidst picturesque snow-clad mountains on a huge houseboat in Dal Lake. More than 7,000 people use this post office every year and is still growing strong. In fact, the surprising factor here is that it is not the only floating post office in India but also in the world, which makes it a unique piece of architecture. Being one of its kind architectures, this post office has now become an important place of a tourist Kashmir itinerary. Now we'll move to our next segment, that is current affair. Today's current affair is about the app Money to help visually challenged to identify currency notes. Recently, the Reserve Bank of India, RBI, has launched a mobile app, Mobile Aided Note Identifier, that is Money. The visually challenged people can identify the denominations of a currency note by using the mobile app Money. This application also works offline once installed. This application scans the currency notes using the camera of the mobile phone and also gives audio output in Hindi and English. This app does not authenticate a note as either genuine or counterfeit. But overall, it is going to be a very helpful app for visually challenged people. So scholars, I hope you like this segment. Now we'll see our homework. Today you have to find the answer of this question. So your question is, name the only food that does not spoil. So scholars, with this, we come to end of this video. Goodbye, scholars.